Hello everyone, welcome to Short Notes series presented by Competitive Academia. The topic of discussion is IUCN. IUCN was established in 1948. It was previously called as the International Union for the Protection of Nature and the World Conservation Union. The IUCN is a short acronym for International Union for Conservation of Nature, which is an international organization working in the field of nature conservation and sustainable use of natural resources. It is the global authority on the status of the natural world and the measures needed to safeguard it. It is involved in data gathering and analysis, research, field projects, advocacy and education. Its headquarters is located in Gland, Switzerland. There are three conventions which are concerned with IUCN. The first is World Cultural and Natural Heritage, which was established in 1972. The IUCN has co-drafted the World Heritage Convention with UNESCO and has been involved as the official advisory body on nature from the onset. The second is CITES. The Convention on International Trade in Endangered Species of Wild Flora and Fauna was established in 1974. IUCN is a signatory party and the CITES Secretariat was originally launched with IUCN. The third is Ramsar Convention. The Convention on Wetlands of International Importance was established in 1975. The Secretariat is still administered from IUCN's headquarters. A Montreux record is maintained, which is register of wetland sites where ecological changes have occurred or likely to occur as a result of technological development, pollution or other human interference. At present, we have two sites in the list, that is Montreux record. The first one is Loktak Lake and the second is Keoladeoi National Park. The Loktak Lake is located in Manipur and Keoladeoi National Park is located in Rajasthan. We have 37 sites which are wetland of international importance in the Ramsar list. The IUCN Red List contains a list of threatened species which has been established in 1964. It has evolved to become the world's most comprehensive information source on the global extinction risk, status of animal, fungus and plant species. The IUCN Red List is a critical indicator of the health of world's biodiversity. Far more than a list of species and their status, it is a powerful tool to inform and catalyze action for biodiversity conservation and policy change, critical to protecting the natural resource we need to survive. It provides information about the range, population size, habitat and ecology, use, trade, threats and conservation action that will help inform necessary conservation decisions. The Red List categorizes itself into three main subdivisions. They are extinct, threatened, and least concern. The extinct has been further subdivided into extinct and extinct in the wild. The threatened has been subdivided into three subdivisions. They are critically endangered, endangered, and vulnerable. The least concern is divided into two subcategories. They are near threatened and least concern. Another subcategory is data deficient, which contains names of those species where enough information is not provided, or their abundance or distribution to estimate the risk of extinction is not available. That's all for this video. We'll come up with a new topic tomorrow. Till then, thank you for listening and like, share and subscribe to our videos and our channel for more such informational videos.